Welcome to another edition of Fast Pitch Friday. On this episode here, I want to talk about the trap bar deadlift in regards to softball pitchers. So I love this exercise here because it teaches players how to have powerful hip extension off the mound, which is something you definitely need to be able to play the sport of softball. Some coaches tend to avoid this exercise because they're afraid that softball players are going to hurt their low back. And for me, I think it's just coaching and doing little tweaks with their deadlift to make sure that it's a safe motion. So the first issue that I see in regards to deadlifting is a lot of players will wear shoes when deadlifting. The shoe sometimes has a heel lift, right? So if you imagine a shoe, most of the time it's going to bias the player forward. So more weight can be on their toes. So when that happens, when they're going down to deadlift here, the weight's going to be more forward, and most of the time it's just a bad biomechanical position, and they end up hurting their back. So going to something where it's a more minimalist shoe or even barefoot, I much prefer that. And I always tell athletes it's almost like jumping in the air. So if you're going to go for a vertical jump, your feet and the pressure in your feet are equal. It's not biased to the toes because you can't jump from here and you can't jump from heels. So get into a position where you feel like you can jump in the air, all right? Two, when you set up for your deadlift, you don't want to think chest to the ground, because if you're in this position here, it's more like an RDL. And what's going to happen is players tend to have the mindset of pulling the deadlift off the ground instead of pushing with their feet. So if you go to pull the deadlift, the first thing that's going to break is your back, and it's going to round up like this. So get them in a mindset where you're going to ask them to push the ground away, okay? So they're going to lock in their lats here and then drive through their feet, okay? Another way to fix that is shoulder blades. So kids will tend to shrug or push their shoulder blades together when they go to deadlift. You don't want to do that. One, it shortens your arm and you're not going to be able to create enough tension in your lats. So I use like a seatbelt analogy. You want to buckle each shoulder blade down with your lats and keep them buckled the entire time as you're deadlifting. So when you grab here, buckle your shoulder blades down to your back pocket and make sure they're sealed, okay? Lastly, during the lockout, some players will tend to extend through their low back as a lockout. So they're not using any of their hips to finish the motion. So when they come up, they'll drive up and they kind of arch like this. So if you see this big arch here, most likely they're extending through the low back and they're actually gonna feel it in their low back, all right? So one tool I use to help them use their butt to finish is just say, hey, finish with your hips hard through the front, all right? So when they come up, make sure your hips are higher than the knees, use your butt to finish the motion, and I always tell them to squeeze a quarter between their butt cheeks. That really, really helps. So use those three tools to help players learn how to deadlift correctly and more safely.